some of the worst people in the GOP took the opportunity yesterday during these Twitter hearings to grandstand, to pepper the people there to testify with questions that made no sense because they're based on conspiracy theories. So you had, I'm not gonna make you listen to all this, by the way. You had Marjorie Greene saying that Twitter had coordinated with the CIA to ban her account. They didn't have much to say about that because that's nonsense. She just made it up. She said repeatedly that they violated her by shadow banning her. They did not. She was temporarily restricted several times for knowingly, intentionally, repeatedly violating COVID misinformation guidelines, and eventually banned for her calls for political violence and overturning the results of elections and all that. That's not a violation. That's them finally, belatedly doing their, I would say, ethical obligation to, if you're gonna have standards and practices, to actually abide by them. You have her then turning to, I love this rant that she gives about AOC being a perpetual victim. You're talking about the CIA trying to ban your account and how everyone's violating you because they won't let you lie about vaccines. But yes, no, it's AOC that's, she's the victim. But even that wasn't as deranged perhaps as Lauren Boebert. So I apologize to your ears. Here is a bit of the Congresswoman.
Mr. Roth, Ms. Gaddy, did either of you approve the shadow banning of my account at Lauren Boebert? Yes or no?
No, I did not.
Not to the best of my recollection.
Well, let me refresh your memory because on March 12th, 2021, and Mr. Roth, I know you looked at it because Fascist Twitter 1.0 had a public interest exceptions policy, which means for members of Congress to be shadow banned, it had to go before you, Mr. Roth. So I'll ask again, did you shadow ban my account? Yes or no?
Again, not to the best of my recollection.
So the answer is, Mr. Roth, yes, you did. I found out last night from Twitter staff that you suppressed my account for this tweet. It's a freaking joke about Hillary Clinton being angry that she couldn't rig her election. It's a joke.
So look, I don't particularly care about any of the execs at Twitter. I will defend them in this case because it's understandable that the staff at Twitter might not have known that she was joking because it's very rarely actually clear she's not funny and she doesn't seem to get that. But regardless, the fact that she is part of a political movement that had spent months at that point denying the results of elections and trying to get mobs in different states and in DC to overturn the results of the election, pretending that your comment was just a joke, isn't a good defense. They were trying to stop democracy from dying. And in any event, the reason they kept saying, not to the best of their knowledge, no, we didn't, and she had to just keep insisting that they did, is that she cannot be specific and use words the way they're intended to be used. You could say, did you briefly, temporarily suspend my account as a result of this specific tweet? That is what they actually did. And she asked them that, they would have said yes, and then she could have lost her mind or whatever. Instead, she has to use this buzzword on the right, shadow banning, which means nothing and everything simultaneously. They did not shadow ban her. That's not actually what they did, but she has to present herself as a victim. Every single Republican in the country has to constantly say that they're being disadvantaged by social media, no matter how much interactions they're actually getting on social media. And that is why she didn't get the moment that she wanted. They didn't have to admit to it because they hadn't actually done it. And she just pressed forward because she's not actually that clever. She didn't plan ahead for any of this. You have people like Maxwell Frost and AOC and Porter and all of that who assemble traps rhetorically that people walk into. But Marjorie Greene and Lauren Boebert are not those people. They really want the moments, and the bar is set so low that it doesn't matter that they biffed the whole thing. Their audience is still gonna love it. But it wasn't the moment that she wanted it to be.
But I won again with 51% of the vote. Just took a lot longer to get there. But you know, throughout all of this, I was telling you, you know, God was really pressing on my heart the story of Elijah. He said the true God will answer by fire. And yeah, those who worshiped Baal, they believed that Baal was the true God. And he said, Elijah said, prove it. If Baal is the true God, tell him to answer by fire. And they're calling for him, they're screaming, they're hollering, they're cutting themselves, they're acting a fool. You know, we've seen that like in 2020 riots and stuff. But their God didn't show up. Elijah was.
Oh, Lauren Boebert. All right, but that wasn't the end of it. She continued on with her crazy comparison. So let's watch that.
Well, maybe cry a little bit louder. Right. Maybe he can't hear you. Maybe he's sleeping. Maybe he's on vacation. I love that so much. And then he went and he said, you know what? I'm going to do you one better. I don't want you to say that this is some kind of fluke, some sort of combustion that just happened. I'm going to drench the altar with fire or with water three times. Three times he went and drenched the altar with fire and God with water, and God still showed up by fire. And that's what he was showing me with this election.
Yeah.
He said, it may look impossible in the natural, right, that there will not be a victory. You may hear the voices, you may hear other people, but I am going to show up. And he did.
It was revealed to Lauren Boebert in a dream that she would win her election, which she said it might be really difficult. I just need everyone to remember that Lauren Boebert's district is heavily Republican. Like, it was not even supposed to be in question that she might lose her race. So the fact that it was as close as it was, you know, it just goes to show how hard the Democratic candidate Adam Frisch worked in that district, but also the Democratic Party within the district. But yeah, so she squeezed by just a fraction of the votes. We got a graphic. I believe it was 500 votes, about 500 votes that she beat this man by in her race this year. And she's referencing the Bible a lot, but I need you all to remember that if she's even able to read, she probably has not read the Bible. Do we have
that? They made life hell on earth with their envy, wanton killing. I don't know what a wanton killing is. I'm gonna have to look that one up. But it sounds interesting, and I don't think I want to.
Wanton killing, by the way. For anybody who was confused by that, I don't think the Bible makes reference to wantons at all. Wanton killing. So she's there displaying her lack of knowledge on the Bible, as well as her, you know, very striking illiteracy. Dan?
Given the modern Republican Party, I was really ready to like put my foot over the brakes when she was talking about wanton things and things like, oh, this is gonna get real racist real quick. Oh God, oh God. But either the clip ended before that, or at least she decided not to do that. But yeah, I think what was revealed in that second clip that we played was the part where she's like, okay, well, it doesn't matter if you're hearing voices or you're seeing these signs. Like, that's where people should pause and go, elected politician seeing signs and voices on what to do. That's either, you know, madness or a really good cop out for whatever you want, or whatever, you know, sort of fate that you want to put out there. Like, after the fact, you can say it was divine destiny. This was God's like intention. This is the stuff that like kings and queens back like 10, like 1,000 years ago used to say. Random things would happen like, oh, we got more rain this season. Thanks to me being in power and God being aligned with that, things are happy now. Like, this is one of the older tricks in the book, quite literally. It's just that this is a book that, yeah, again, like you're saying, we're not sure she's read.